All right, the final episode of the Steel Samurai arc. Ooh, that was a close one, huh, Mia? Really? Too bad. I'm sorry I missed it. But Maya? Who's Maya? What happened? I can't keep doing this voice for Maya. I'm gonna go back to my old voice for her. Well, I think I've got a pretty good idea who did it. All I need is a motive and proof. Wow, good going, Nick. Under the initial trial system, tomorrow is the last day I have. Yeah, the initial, quote, initial trial system. Initial trial? What's that? That's the new court system they introduced 2 or 3 years ago. They had so many cases in the system, they decided to speed up the whole process. So, under that system, trials that have to end in 3 days? Yeah, pretty much. Well, we have no time to waste. Again, this is not our job, Phoenix, blah, 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 but... who are we seeing at the detention? Why is Will still in here? Mr. Wright, you did very well again today. Thank you. Thanks. Could you not look like you're about to burst into tears? Wow, Nick, you must have really wowed him in there. Could you wipe that grin off your face? Yeah, that grin actually freaks me out, Maya. AWP, only 1 day left. Let's make a count. Yes. Though there's not really anything I can do to help. I'm not really sure what I could do either. Please, this is no laughing matter. Could you tell me more about Miss Vasquez?
The producer? She's well respected in the industry. They say she's a genius.
A genius?
She's been at Global Studios for 5 years now. Right or wrong, nobody dares tell her different these days.
Why is that?
Ever since she came on board, we've had nothing but hits. Global Studios went on knees, but she picked it up and made it shine. Oh, and...
And what?
Nothing, forget it. I've only heard rumors, anyhow.
Can you tell me anything about Mr. Manella?
Oh, he used to be a minor straight-to-video director. Something in his work caught Vasquez's eyes. She brought the Steel Samurai idea to him, and now everyone knows the name Sal Manella. I hear he's pretty much her beck and call, though. Whenever she says jump, he asks how high and all that.
Yeah, because he's fat. I was wondering about Mr. Hammer. He was a big star back in the day, right? But then he just dropped off the face of the earth.
Oh. Yes, you're right. In fact, he was my role model when I started in the business. But he just stopped taking on big roles. That's when he began appearing in little productions at Global.
Nani?
I was really looking forward to a sequel to Samurai Summer.
He just gave up being a star 5 years ago. Actually, now that I think about it, I was right when Miss Vasquez came to Global.
5 years ago. Interesting. Oh, good. The old windbag sure is quiet today. You know, this place really is peaceful like this. Nick? I think her guard's down. Yeah. Bet we could even eat those donuts in the guard station if we wanted.
You eat, you die!
Woo! She's alive! Hooray for that. I was wondering about Dee Vasquez as a producer.
Oh, studio bigwigs love her!
So she always gets her way. She's bitter. You not like the producer?
Look, studio people don't want me talking about her, so sorry.
I ask you about Sal Manella, the director?
Sal? He's a pushover. Does whatever Vasquez tells him to. Treats him like dirt. I think he likes it.
Uh-huh.
How would anyone like being treated like dirt? Doesn't make any sense, does it, Nick? No, it doesn't, Maya. I keep forgetting you're only 16 or 17. About Mr. Hammer.
Arrgh! Heard about what you said today, Cheeky Whippersnapper? Poor old Hammer, he dragged his star down from the sky and stomp on it. Calling him a criminal, a thief. I won't forget this.
Oh, she's really pissed this time.
You listen to me, Whippersnapper, my poor old Hammer would never do such a thing. Why would he steal Power's costumes or sneak on by me? He would never stoop so low, impossible.
Okay. I guess they're not filming today either. Not want to see them filming. I did want to see them filming just one time. I'm sure I'll be over and done by tomorrow. You can come see them film then. I guess. This is where you found the bottle of sleeping pills, right? Yeah. I wonder if there's any other clues lying around.
Yarr! No, 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 no touching! Oh, sorry about that, pal. Didn't mean to frighten you. Didn't mean I almost had a heart attack. I guess I could be a little dramatic sometimes. Suppose it's the actor in me.
Dramatic indeed.
Anyway, I'm here to examine the plate on that table.
Are you looking for the sleeping pills?
Yeah, pal. Traces thereof.
So you're looking for traces of the sleeping pills. How?
For a thorough examination, I gotta take that plate back to the precinct. I have the capabilities to make a cursory examination here. The science guy gave me some testing solution. This reacts to the sleeping pills, see? This traces it to change color.
Wow, neat. Well, Detective Gumshoe, what are you waiting for?
Now, everything in due time, pal. Well, the testing solution on the plate changed color, all right.
So he was drugged. The food in this place had been laced with sleeping pills.
Looks like it.
Found the employee area. On it are traces of sleeping pills and large bone. How goes your investigation?
Tell you the truth, it's a real mess, pal. Some people think we should pursue the case we already have against Powers. Some people think we should switch suspects.
What do you think, Detective Gumshoe?
Well, pal, I hate to admit it, but I'm not so sure I buy the case against Mr. Powers anymore.
Yeah, you think, Gumshoe?
Kind of feel bad for Mr. Edgeworth, though.
Why do you feel bad about him?
Mr. Edgeworth is out of control. He was in the waiting room and he crushed his paper cup with hot, hot coffee in it.
Whoa.
Talk about burns, pal.
Wow, the fury of Edgeworth. Yeah, crushing paper cups. Cups? Bottles?
Hey, whatever happened with that empty bottle anyway?
Oh, I said that.
Oh, the bottle of sleeping pills? Well, I got some news for you about that. They found the victim Jack Hammer's fingerprints on the bottle.
So that means...
Yep, sounds like the one who put Powers to sleep was none other than the victim.
I was right. There's Jack Hammer's fingerprints. So that pretty much confirms that Hammer did indeed set this up.
Oh, hello. What are you doing here? Oh, I was just cleaning up the dressing room. SWP won't be using anymore, so...
Nani? Noosta!
But WP's innocent. Yeah, and I'm really grateful for all you've done. But this week is the last episode of Steel Samurai.
Nani?
I wonder if I could ask you about Mr. Hammer.
Yes?
On the day of the murder, he went to Studio 2.
Huh? I thought he went to Studio 1. He stole the Steel Samurai costume, too.
Nani?
Why would Mr. Hammer do such a thing like that?
Oh. I guess the rumor must be true, then. The rumor?
Yeah, Ms. Vasquez, that producer, had some kind of hold on Hammer. Had some dirt on him. He'd do anything she said, apparently.
Some dirt?
What dirt? Dirt, you know, bad stuff. I know what dirt means. About 5 years ago, they were filming a movie starring Mr. Hammer. They were using some new studio, the Studio 2. Sort of accident happened during the filming. After that, they never used Studio 2 again. They left the film set the way it was, too.
film set. Was that trailer part of the film set then? What do you mean, The Last Samurai? Steel Samurai. I know it's a shock, but nothing can be done to save it now. Whoever really did kill Mr. Hammer also signed Steel Samurai's death warrant. Oh, no. Also, I hear that Global Studios is going to change its programming. They're not going to make kid shows anymore.
Nani?
I don't know. It's sad, but that's what Global Studios decided. Why aren't they going to make kill shows anymore? Studio bigwigs don't want Steel Samurai around anymore. They want to forget all this ever happened. They want it quiet, you understand? How can they just do that? What about all the kids who love the Steel Samurai? It's okay. I'm sure the kids will be fine. They'll find a new hero to follow. No, that can't be true. If the program just ends, they'll be heartbroken for sure. Nick, say something. Yeah. Here, take a look at this.
Take that!
What's this? This is why you can't stop the Steel Samurai. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Neither do I, Nick. Funny, I don't either. Let's try that again. Oh.
Take that!
It's alright. No, I didn't mean to do that.
Take that.
This is a fan collected all these photographs. The kids love the Steel Samurai. So it shouldn't be canceled just because some adults could save face. I think you would understand that better than anyone. You're right. Okay. But what can I do? Well, for starters, can you tell me something? Tell me what it is that Global Studios is so intent on hiding. Tell me about this accident 5 years ago. Okay. Could you tell us what happened 5 years ago? Well, I can tell you what I've heard. Apparently 5 years ago, someone died and it was Hammer's fault. Someone died? It was an accident, of course. Anyway, producer Ms. Vasquez managed to hush it up. That's the dirt she had on Mr. Hammer? That's why Mr. Hammer couldn't do anything, Ms. Vasquez. That's why he would do anything while she said, asked him to. But it was an accident, right? Why didn't they just make it public? Well, you know, Mr. Hammer was a big star back then. They were afraid about what would happen to his career before it got out. See. You know who knows more about this? Miss Oldbag. She was here at the studios back then, you know. Thanks, we'll try asking her. Oh, good.
What do you want? You're still slinking around? You like to play so much, why don't you go take it over for me?
The windbag doesn't look so good.
Everybody's doing their darndest to forget Hammer. Who do they think made Global Studios what it is today anyway? Hammer did. It's all due to Hammer.
Starting to froth at the mouth, Nick. Maybe we should keep a safe distance? I wanted to ask you about 5 years ago.
Who told? Who did you hear that from? Nichols!
Nichols? Nichols, Nick. Penny Nichols, that assistant we talked to. Oh, right. Anyway, word about the accident. During filming with Jackhammer. Killed a man, didn't he?
Whippersnappers! Dredging up dirt in someone's past like that and recently departed, no less. Suppose you think it's fun?
No, I'm just doing my job to protect Mr. Powers.
You claim that Hammer stole Powers' costume? Expect me to believe that rubbish? You have some kind of proof.
The Hammer stole his costume? Yeah. Sorry, Miss Oldbag, we do have proof. I can prove that Mr. Hammer stole Mr. Power's costume. Yeah, the sleeping pills.
Take that!
Here's my proof.
What? What's a little empty bottle supposed to prove?
bottle of sleeping pills. Mr. Hammer's fingerprints on it.
What does that prove? I'm sure old Hammer has some sleepless nights. Where's proof that he used those pills on Powers?
Take that! Mr. Powers ate a T-bone steak for lunch, correct?
Well, yes, so?
This is the plate that he used to eat that steak. There are traces of sleeping pill powder on the plate.
I see. Poor Hammer. Did wrong, Hammer, rest your soul.
Soul bag?
Okay, you win. I'll talk. Tired, see? Real tired of holding it all in.
Soul bag.
You're right. 5 years ago, there was an accident. A fatal one, that too. It was a humdinger. It was a real humdinger. It was that dinger over there. It hummed like a humdinger. That fatal accident, when I had diabetes, it was a humdinger.
What's worse, paparazzi took a photo of it.
Photo, well, it caused quite a stir. Guess who made it all better? Vasquez.
He has ties to the mafia, you know.
She silenced that paparazzi. That was just the beginning. After that, she became a force to be reckoned with here at the studio.
I see.
But you have to understand, poor old Hammer never meant to harm anyone.
Old bag.
Hold on a minute.
Poor Miss Old Bag.
Here, take this.
Photograph? Hey, it's that bent fence.
Chotomate! This is the picture.
Is this trailer Studio 2?
Hammer was supposed to fight with a bad guy on top of those stairs there. He pushed the other actor and the man fell onto the flower box fence.
But how did you get this?
It was a long time ago. I don't feel much like talking about it.
I understand. It was an accident involving Jack Hammer. Okie dokie. Time to go to Studio 2. Back, Nick, to the day of the murder. Mr. Hammer put on the Steel Samurai costume. And he left from here to go to Studio 2? Right. Why? I wonder if someone called him, like the director or the producer. Well, that's what we're going to find out there. Oh, good. Hey, Nick. It was Vasquez. Hello? Hello? Maya! She's trying to be polite.
Watching the clouds.
All she had to say, apparently. Excuse me, Mr. Hammer came here on the day of the murder and...
Shh.
Perhaps he didn't hear me. Watching the clouds. Not interested in talking to you. Something, Nick, she's really ticking me off. Oh, dear. Mr. Powers wasn't the killer. You don't have to cancel the Steel Samurai.
I think I'm tired of the Steel Samurai.
You did it. Nick, she did it. She's the killer. My fae blood speaks to me. I know it. I know it. Oh, dear. I was wondering if you could tell me about Mr. Manella?
You must talk about that man. Perhaps you could talk about it in the trailer.
By ourselves. Yourselves? Okay. Wasn't the assistant cleaning up yesterday? Funny, it still seems pretty messy in here. Guess she was still on a high from getting that rare card she needed. Looks like they were designing a set to use this for the Steel Samurai show. Got some figures and for how much the set costs. Can't believe they spend that much money on those sets. An old movie poster. Dynamite Samurai starring Jack Hammer. Guess Mr. Hammer used to be that quite the star.
Thing in here that could be a clue to some paper cups and crumpled documents. This is where they had that meeting. There are documents, paper cups scattered all around. An old movie poster with Singing Samurai starring Jack Hammer. How does Samurai have to sing about chopping off heads? Oh my god. That movie was the best. It was about a samurai who sings his way to fame and fortune. Mr. Hammer was a very accomplished singer, you know. Singing Samurai stars. What's next? Ninja Ballet? Samurai Summer, starring Jack Hammer. This poster is quite old. Wow, it's been years since I saw that show. One of those typical summer romance stories, but it was great. Typical summer romance with a samurai on a horse. Fascinating. Glasses frosted, can't see outside. Okay. Well, there's nothing out here, or nothing in there, so... How about we look at this fence? There's some flowers here. Oh, so pretty! They're taking good care of these. If we get too close, that fence looks dangerous. Hey. Wait a second. Hey, D. Hey, D. Take a look at these photos. Not even looking. Where?
Nani?
Where did you get that? Old bag. Old? I mean security lady, this old bag, Nick. Right, anyway. Miss Vasquez, you hid this incident from the press, didn't you? And you used it to control Mr. Hammer. The wind. Huh? Gotten stronger, don't you think? The wind. The conversation interests me. Let's talk about it more inside the trailer. Nick, she went inside the trailer.
What do you mean, this trailer?
Game. Well then, what was it you were talking about? Why she's so eager to talk about it? Miss Vasquez? You were using that accident. You were blackmailing Mr. Hammer so you could control him, weren't you? That's why he was doing kids' shows for petty change. I'm a blackmailer now. That's what it was, wasn't it? I mean, sure, it was an accident, but you used it to drag down Mr. Hammer down from his rightful place as a star. Oh? I haven't pulled anyone down from anywhere. Mr. Hammer's career went sour on his own accord. But you were the cause. You pressured him. And to think it was just an accident. Excuse me? What is this all about? You keep saying accident, accident. How are you so sure? What do you mean? Must I spell everything out for you? Think. What would it be if it wasn't an accident? No. No way. You mean Mr. Hammer did it on purpose? That is what I mean. What's your proof? Can you prove it? Just think. Would you have let me run his life for 5 years over a mere accident? And I ran him hard, believe you me. But the security lady said it was an accident. Oh well, she's a big fan of Hammer's, you see. She jumped on the reporter who brought that photo into the studio. She wrenched it out of his hand, she did. Gave him a few bruises, too. That's why she had the photo. She's an old fool. Of course, all the reporter would need is the negatives. Could have made a copy. He didn't. The only copy of that photo is the one you hold. Give it to me. Now. What? This is valuable evidence. Boys. I can guarantee you I can take out every single one of them. Who are they? Professionals. They're good at erasing various things. What do you think? Would you like to be erased? But
Nani?
The trial ends tomorrow? How unfortunate. It's a shame you'll have to miss it. Tell me why. Why do you want this photograph so badly? This is Mr. Hammer's dirt, no? Why would D. Vasquez care about it at all? I'm sure you'll have plenty of time to think about that, where you're going. So long, friends. Boys, erase away.
No!
there! Heard everything, pal! Steve Vasquez, you're coming down to the precinct with me now!
Not bad. Very well. Here's this contest will be decided tomorrow, then, in court. I'll be looking forward to it.
Hey, you okay, pal? Sorry I was a little late with my entrance. I don't get many chances to practice that sort of thing.
Thank you, Gumshoe. Thank you. I was really scared.
Huh? Don't mention it, pal. Just doing my job.
Detective Gumshoe?
Sorry, it's just I wanted to say that line ever since I became the detective, is all. Okay, I've got one more job to do today. We'll run into each other again soon.
Well, Nick, looks like we're getting close to the bottom of this.
Who's at the bottom? Steve Vasquez.
Twists and turns. Dun dun dun.
Nah, just kidding. The final day.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers.
Prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
Defense is ready, Your Honor.
Today will be the final day of this trial. Hope both the prosecution and the defense will be able to present decisive evidence. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth, your opening statement.
Yesterday's session, the defense presented us with a new theory for this case. He claims the scene of the crime was in fact Studio 2. Today I will call on people present in the Studio 2 trailer that day. With their testimonies, the truth will become clear.
Very well.
Edgeworth seems to be a bit on edge today.
First witness, Mr. Edgeworth.
Prosecution calls Ms. D. Vasquez to the stand. D. Vasquez is a producer who was present in the Studio 2 trailer that day. Why is she smoking in court? Will the witness state her name and occupation? D. Vasquez, I'm a producer for the Global Studios. The day of the murder, you were in Studio 2. As everyone here knows, yes? Just like needless banter. You must pontificate. Do it while I'm out here.
Very well, Ms. Vasquez. Please give the court your testimony concerning the day of the murder.
Nick, I know she did it. Make her pay.
Right. Guilty, I'll catch her with her pants down, so to speak.
Witness testimony!
Entered the trailer, a little before noon. The meeting began at 12 sharp. It ended at 4. There was to be a rehearsal afterwards, so we went to Studio 1. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. At 2:30, we took a 15-minute break in the meeting. Sal and I ate T-bone steaks on the table in front of the trailer. We found Hammer's body later when we all went to Studio 1. That's all. How did they drive the van if the road was blocked?
I have a question about one part of your testimony. You were fatigued, so you had Sal take you.
The van. It was a van at Studio 2. I had him take me in that. Thought it might be risky to walk with that monkey's head toppling over. Manella used this van to drive Vasquez to Studio 1 after the meeting trailer. Why would they have to use a van to walk that far? Ridiculous.
I see. Very well. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
The final battle, Nick. Let's do this.
Cross-examination! Entered the trailer, a little before noon. By yourself? Yes. You didn't stop in the employee area? No. Are you always this purse? Yes. Meeting began at 12 o'clock sharp and ended at 4. Did no one leave during the meeting? No one. Come on, let's talk a bit more about that. The witness did not come here to engage in idle conversation. Stop interrupting the testimony. Same can be said to you, Mr. Edgeworth. Please stop banging your little desk. It hurts my ears. There was to be a rehearsal afterwards, so we went to Studio One. When exactly was that? I've forgotten. Maybe you could try remembering? No. The meeting ended at 4 o'clock and the rehearsal was scheduled for 5 o'clock. I would think it would be between those times. You would think? Come on. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. Hold on. You had Sal take you. What does that mean? It means what I just said. I had Sal take me in the Studio 2 van. Oh, right. At 2:30, we took a 15-minute break in the meeting. What were you doing during that time? Don't hit your desk. It irritates me. Yeah, Mr. Wright. Oops. It was a 15-minute break. Sal and I ate T-bone steaks on the table in front of the trailer. You have someone who can verify this? No. No, I mean someone else. One person is enough. She committed murder during that break. She wouldn't have had time to eat a T-bone steak. Yeah, we know she didn't eat the steak, because there's no bone on there. Alright, I think she's being pretty used to being the boss. I'm sure you can find some kind of contradiction in what she said somewhere. Entered, except we know she didn't eat the bone. Man, we need to... She said she ate in front of the trailer. This was taken from the employee area. How can we prove that we know that she didn't eat the steak? I don't think this is it. Objection! As I thought. Then you ate a T-bone steak. But I say you did not.
Watch this now, Mr. Wright.
Look at this.
It's a plate.
This plate was on the table in the employee area. As you can see, a large bone has been left behind. Mr. Wright, need I remind you it was a T-bone steak? Exactly my point. Remember, if you will, Ms. Vasquez and Mr. Manila ate at a table outside the trailer. Yet there are no bones left on the plates. The plates were bare. Ms. Vasquez? Tell me, how can a person eat a T-bone steak and not leave the bone? I think I know how. You ate the bone too. Yeah, there you go, Phoenix. You didn't eat any steaks during that break. You took your steak and threw it somewhere. Like the incinerator.
I see. What was Miss Vasquez doing during her break?
Is it obvious, Your Honor? Meeting the Steel Samurai? Picking on Salmonella, no. Meeting the Steel Samurai. She was meeting with the Steel Samurai.
Order! Are you saying?
Yes, Your Honor. Miss Vasquez left the trailer to eat her steak. She ran into the Steel Samurai, and then you did it. You killed him with your own hands.
Mr. Wright! Isn't that a little presumptuous?
What kind of stunt are you trying to pull here, Wright? Let him claim what he wants. You say I did it? Yes. Fascinating. And here I was worrying that today would be as boring as all the rest. Very well. Let us have a battle of wits, you and I. Any day. Biatch! Let's see. What was the murder weapon again? Oh yes, the samurai spear. Yes? I am, as you can see, a woman of petite stature. How could I possibly use that heavy spear as a weapon? You couldn't. I think it would be a great deal of difficulty using that as a weapon. Pretty much anyone would. Huh. You see? Yes. However, that has no bearing in this case. Meaning? The samurai spear was not the murder weapon.
Nani?
What is the meaning of this? The spear was found lying next to the victim's body.
I have proof, Your Honor. I can prove that the samurai spear was not used as a murder weapon.
Take that!
Wrong, Mr. Wright.
I haven't said anything yet.
I know you well enough by now and know where you're going to present the wrong evidence.
That's to do with my fey blood. What? It was broken, I guess?
Take that!
Oh. I present my proof, the so-called murder weapon. But that is the murder weapon. Not so fast. Remember that the spear broke during the morning action scene run-through? But someone fixed the spear. It was a security lady. She fixed it with duct tape. Now tell me, how is it possible for someone to stab a man who was wearing a thick costume with his chest? With this through the chest?
Order! Order!
Mr. Wright, what are you driving at? Think about what you're... Silence! I'm the one testifying here, and I will be heard. Are you quite sane? Are you even aware of what you're saying? If the samurai spear was not the murder weapon, then pray tell what was. How was Hammer killed?
Well, Mr. Wright, can you tell us what kind of weapon was used to kill Mr. Hammer?
Would I make a claim like that if I couldn't tell you what the weapon was?
I'm afraid your confidence can sometimes be unfounded, Mr. Wright. Very well, let's see the murder weapon then.
Take that!
Look at this photo.
What is this? Why, that's Jack Hammer standing at the top of the stairs. Order! Order! If I cannot have order, this trial will be suspended. Mr. Wright, what is this all about?
This photograph is from 5 years ago. There's an unfortunate accident at Global Studios. This is a photo of that very accident. Not a word of this was leaked to the outside. It was a close-kept secret at the studios. What does this have to do with the current case? Mr. Edgeworth, you still can't see it? See the fallen man in this photo? See how the fence post pierced him through the chest?
Nani?
You saying?
Yes. What happened 5 years ago? Has happened again!
Mr. Wright, continue!
It's 2:30 p.m. on the day of the murder. Ms. D. Vasquez meets Jack Hammer outside Studio 2 trailer. And she did it. She pushed Mr. Hammer off the stairs onto the fence. Just like Mr. Hammer had done himself 5 years ago. But whether she did it on purpose or by accident, I cannot say.
In other words, victim Mr. Hammer died in the same way that caused another man to die. 5 years ago!
Precisely. Ironic, isn't it?
Very creative, Mr. Wright.
I could use a man like you on my script-writing staff. You deny what I say is true? Mr. Wright? Let's say, for the sake of argument, that Hammer died at the trailer, as you say. If the body was found in Studio One, was it not? And in the evil magistrate's costume, no less. Are you then claiming that I carried the body to Studio One and returned to the trailer in the span of 15 minutes? How could I have disposed of the body? Break in the meeting at the trailer lasted 15 minutes from 2:30 to 2:45. Jack Hammer had been pushed off the stairs to his death, then carried to Studio One and placed inside of his costume. There wasn't enough time.
Indeed. Well, Mr. Wright, how could she have dealt with the body?
He hadn't moved. Or she had another way to carry the body, other than her own hands. For instance, the van? Actually, for that matter, there was no need for it to do the deed in 15 minutes. And there was a way for you to carry that body. Interesting. Let's hear it then.
Mr. Wright, please show us how she carried the body.
Come on, Judge.
Take that!
Ms. Vasquez, you carried the body to Studio One. And you used the studio van to do it. Recall your testimony. There was to be rehearsal afterwards, so we went to Studio One. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. There's a van in there, right? I had Sal drive me. You used the van to carry the body to Studio One. Then before everyone else got there, you put the body into the magistrate costume.
Objection.
Hold on, Wright. Don't forget it was Sal Manello who drove the van. Are you suggesting that Mr. Manello was a conspirator? Of course he wasn't. Ha! Without Mr. Manello noticing anything, she put the body in the van, then managed to put the body into the costume? Are you seriously suggesting that's possible? Of course I'm not serious. Ha! Ha! Huh? I was kidding. To our lighten up proceedings.
Light?
Lighten! You can't lighten up a murder!
Mr. Wright! The court requests you refrain from making claims in jest.
Yes, Your Honor. Of course, Sal Manello has to be a conspirator. The body had to be placed in the van and to put it in the costume. There's no way Ms. Vasquez could have done that alone. She could have gotten her cronies to do it. And also, don't forget they had to dispose of the Steel Samurai costume. They had to because it was covered in Mr. Hammer's blood. They probably burned it in that small incinerator. Well, Ms. Vasquez, shall I continue? No need. Smarter than you look, Mr. Wright. I lose, you win. It was fun. I... win? So, what happens next? Me? You have anything to say? What would you like me to say? Huh? I lost? Something like that? Just said that. Wait, so you mean Steve Vasquez, so it was you! You killed Jackhammer! Who can say? Huh? You sure I did? Mr. Wright, you just engaged a battle of wits. The result of that battle, you proved the possibility that I murdered Hammer. Right. But that's only a possibility. Proof is another thing altogether. You lack decisive proof.
You can't handle my proof, traveler.
Nani!
Order! Mr. Edgeworth, your thoughts?
Of course, it's as the witness says.
Certainly, it does seem very likely she did it, but there's no proof. Edward isn't sure. Well, came here as a witness today. If you no more questions, I'll be leaving now. What do I do now? Ms. Vasquez, you did it. That wasn't a question. Did you do it? No.
Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor.
I'm not sure that question helped this court get any closer to a verdict.
I guess there's no...
Yes, Mr. Wright?
Tell me I can come up with a question while pounding my desk. I did.
You have my sympathies.
Damn. Damn. I'm so far to fail.
As it seems there are no further questions, I would like to end the cross-examination of the witness, Miss Vasquez.
Objection!
Edgeworth?
Yes, Mr. Edgeworth.
I was hoping to come up with a question while I was objecting, Your Honor. I didn't.
I see. Very well.
Objection!
Your Honor! I request that the witness testify again. You're the prosecutor, are you not? Why are you badgering me? I'm your witness. I just want to hear your testimony again. Does it make any sense to you, Your Honor? I don't see what we have anything to gain by repeating the last several minutes.
Mr. Edgeworth, I too see little point in making Miss Vasquez repeat herself. What exactly did you want here to testify about?
Oh, yes.
Indeed. Verily, I say, ergo... I wanted to hear about what happened after they found the body.
After they found the body?
Very well. The witness will testify to the court concerning this matter.
Nick. What did Edgeworth... Who knows? Probably realized she did it too. But... Wasn't he the one who said he always gets a guilty verdict? After all that... Edgeworth. Edgeworth wants to get a guilty verdict.
Witness testimony!
I was with Sal and Old Bag and the security lady when we found the body. The assistant was there too, only Powers was absent. I immediately called the police, then Powers showed up. Security lady, Old Bag, was quite agitated, pointing at Powers saying he did it. I asked to be left out of the proceedings. I went back to the trailer to get my script and direction notes, then I went home.
I see no issues raised by this testimony. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
Hey, Nick, we're really close. Maybe acting tough now. You put her on the spot, she's sure to falter. Find the key you need and twist the truth out of her, Nick.
Right. Cross-examination!
I was with Sal and Old Bag and the security lady when we found the body. What time was that? We were to meet at 5 for the rehearsal, so I'd say it was then. When exactly did you and Mr. Manella arrive at the studio? About 10 minutes before. I wasn't stuffing any bodies into costumes, mind you. Where were the other employees when you got to the studio? They weren't there yet. Well, then you could have put Hammer in that costume with Salmonella's help. Oh? What did I just say? Did I not just say I wasn't stuffing any bodies in any costumes? Try to listen to what people were saying, boy.
Witness will continue her testimony.
Assistant was there too, only Mr. Powers was absent.
Hold it.
Mr. Powers is taking a nap, correct? So he says. Did no one go to call on him? Remember. Remember? What? There's a dead body lying in front of us, yet you expect me to be calm? You only seem calm enough when I accuse you of murder. Wait a second. Wouldn't it be the other way around? The other way around? You discovered a murdered body and one person was missing, right? Wouldn't you normally go looking for the missing person?
I have to agree with the defense on this one. Well, Miss Vasquez?
Glad to be speaking, perhaps. But no one there was thinking very logically, I assure you. Also, without a steel samurai costume, Powers doesn't really stand out. We often left him on the bus at the shooting location. No one noticed when he was missing. Poor Powers.
Well, I suppose that explains that. Very well, Miss Vasquez, you may continue.
Immediately called the police, then the Powers showed up. What was everyone else doing at that time? No one said a thing. It was silent, completely silent. We stood there until Powers finally arrived on the scene. Sorry, I'm late. Then silence, dead silence. Silence.
Hey, Nick.
Why is everyone so quiet? Someone should do something to lighten things up. Security lady old bag was quite agitated, pointing at Powers, saying he did it, he did it. Old bag, security lady. Why does the security lady think Powers had done it? She said because she saw him going towards the studio. Right, Steel Samurai. The detective arrests Mr. Powers based solely on the security lady's word? Perhaps not. She seems to have also given the detective that photograph. Of course, I heard all this after the fact. Photograph. I mean, the one taken by the security camera. Not known for exhibiting the best sense of judgment when it comes to Amber. Something I can use here. I asked to be left out of proceedings. He asked to be left out? Yes. Means that everyone else was being questioned. I'm really not fond of that sort of thing. Whoa! You can't just decide who the police will and won't question. Thankfully, the studio thinks otherwise. They were nice enough to understand that since we were in a meeting, there was no way we could have been involved. Thus, they covered for us. Covered for you. Covered it up for you. Her professionals helped convince everyone they require questioning. Yeah, why can't we just bring Gumshoe on? Like, Gumshoe literally could, like, break this case. Like, he heard her threaten a lawyer. Went back to the trailer to get my script and direction notes. Script and your direction notes? Yes, they're quite valuable. I wouldn't do to have them stolen. No, I guess not. Wait a second. I thought you came to Studio One for a rehearsal. Why did you bring your script and notes? Well, I was under the impression that we wouldn't be able to rehearse anything. Why? There's a murder, after all. What do you think of rehearsing after that? Oh yeah, I guess. Very well. Miss Vasquez, please continue. Objection. Your Honor, I have an objection to the witness's last statement. What? Think. Miss Vasquez said she didn't bring the script because there wouldn't be a rehearsal. Don't you see what that means? You would have to have known about the murder before going to Studio One. Order! Order! Mr. Edgeworth! What you just said is a reasonable observation. However, I find it hard to understand why the prosecution would make such a move. Are you thinking of a career change to a defense? I appreciate the concern, Your Honor. I'll stand by my statement, however, regardless of how the court sees my role here. Now, Ms. Vasquez, do you have an explanation? I can't believe Edgeworth is helping me. The prosecution is in cahoots with the defense. What kind of court is this? No matter. I think you misunderstood me. I had a perfectly good reason to believe there would be no rehearsal. Very well, the witness will change her testimony to reflect this reason. I knew Hammer was injured, so I couldn't do any action. He couldn't do any action, so I left him behind. How did you know about the injury? Yeah. How did I know, Sal? He told me. Now the director, but Sal wasn't there. Everything we've done is now has been... I believe in you, Nick. Go get him. I was with Sal and all that security, but Sal wasn't there. And it wasn't Hammer that was injured. It was Powers. But it wasn't Hammer that was injured. It was Powers that was injured. Hold it. Hold it. There's no way she could have known that Powers was... It was Powers who was injured.
Objection!
You knew that Hammer was injured. Don't you think that's a little funny? I mean, it was the Steel Samurai who was injured. It was Will Powers!
Nani? Mr. Wright, explain yourself.
Yes, Mr. Hammer's dragging his leg in the photo. But that's because he was pretending to be Mr. Powers. Pretending? One person was injured in the run-through that morning. That person was Mr. Powers, not Mr. Hammer. Now, why did you think it was Mr. Hammer who was injured?
No.
I already said it was Sal who told me. That's right, he must have gotten it wrong. I think not. Mr. Manel was at the run-through that morning. He would have known it was Mr. Powers who was injured. He saw it happen. Why would he tell you the wrong person? Ms. Vasquez? Actually, you didn't hear anything from Mr. Manella. You saw Mr. Hammer leaping with your own eyes.
Yes, but wasn't it Mr. Powers who was injured?
Yes, but remember, Mr. Hammer was dragging his leg too. He was pretending to be Mr. Powers. Ah. When he was doing this? Well, it would have been after he put on the Steel Samurai costume and went to Studio 2, where he was murdered. Exactly. Ms. Vasquez, you met him, didn't you? You saw the Steel Samurai limping. And Mr. Hammer was in that Steel Samurai suit. That's why you were confused. That's why you thought it was Mr. Hammer who had been injured that morning.
Order! Order! I will have order!
Witness, you refute this claim? You sneak away out of this one, Vasquez. Very well. I have a question for you. Why are the witnessing... How is this a court that's allowing a witness to question a prosecutor? Or a defense? Why in the world would I want Mr. Hammer dead? Yes, he'd fallen to hard times, but he was a star. I had nothing to gain from his death. Nothing.
Yes, you would need a motive. Why would she have killed the victim? There's a reason it is unclear to this court. Does the defense have anything to say on the matter? In other words, can you prove she had a motive?
Of course I can prove it. Okay. I have proof and I'll show it to you. I present to the court this evidence that Miss Vasquez had motive for the murder. This is my proof.
This is the photo from before?
This photo reveals the motive in this murder. I'm right, aren't I, Ms. Vasquez? 5 years ago, Mr. Hammer was at the height of his fame. With Dee Vasquez's help, a terrible accident was swept under the carpet. Ladies and gentlemen, the case currently up for trial. It began on that day 5 years ago. Ironically enough, that accident... Precipitated Mr. Hammer's fall. His fall from stardom. It weighed him down, no doubt. However, you, Dee Vasquez, used Mr. Hammer. You made him work for you for petty change. Bring us to this present day and Mr. Hammer's last role as the evil magistrate. Yes, undoubtedly it was a constant source of shame for the X-Star.
One moment, Mr. Wright. We are talking about motives here, yet you only have talked about Mr. Hammer. It almost seems as if it was Mr. Hammer who had killed Dee Vasquez, not the other way around. What motive would Miss Vasquez have?
Yes, that's right. According to what you say, I would have no reason to kill Hammer. He was a good source of income for me. I never get rid of useful men. It's a policy of mine.
Mr. Wright, please explain Miss Vasquez's motive for murder.
Okay, allow me to present the court evidence proving her motive. Why would she want to... Path to glory?
Take that!
This is my proof.
And this tells us why Ms. Vasquez wanted to kill Mr. Hammer?
That proves the defense attorney's completely lost his marbles.
Mr. Wright, the court requests that you find your marbles immediately, and I'm afraid I have to penalize you for this court's wasted time.
So close. He's one through, please.
Mr. Wright, I'll ask you again. Please explain Ms. Vasquez's motive for the murder.
Not the same, it's not the book.
Again?
This is my proof.
And this tells us why Miss Vasquez...
Maybe it wasn't her who had motive?
She had no motive, Your Honor. What's that now?
It was Mr. Hammer who was out for blood. All Ms. Vasquez did was push him off the stairs, in self-defense. What's that now? It's simple. Mr. Hammer was intending to kill Ms. Vasquez.
Nani!
Your Honor, Jack Hammer drugged Mr. Powers with sleeping pills. Jack Hammer snuck into the dressing room and stole the Steel Samurai costume. Jack Hammer wore the costume to fool the security lady into thinking it was Powers. And Jack Hammer made his way to the trailer. And for what purpose, you ask? To kill Dee Vasquez, who was so cruelly taken advantage of him all those years. So you did do it, didn't you? Yes. I'm guilty. It was me.
Someone call an ambulance. There's blood everywhere. We're too late. Miss Vasquez.
What? What happened here?
Manuel fell from the trailer stairs. Well, Manuel.
Vasquez, try to remain calm.
No. It was an accident. Hammer was doing an action scene and... No! Manuel! Don't touch him! Don't touch him, Ms. Vasquez! No! Please don't die. Please.
Congratulations, Mr. Wright. I lose. Again.
Mr. Edgeworth, where's Dee Vasquez?
In the waiting lobby, Your Honor. Mom has collected his aber.
I see. Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor.
It appears you have brought about yet another miracle.
Thank you, Your Honor. I think not, Your Honor. Will Powers was innocent. That he should be found so only is natural, not a miracle.
Yes, you're right. Very well. This court finds the defendant, Mr. Will Powers, not guilty! That is all. This court is adjourned.
I don't know what to say. Thank you so much.
Just glad you're okay.
Yes, but it's sad. I know now that Mr. Hammer stole my costume. It was bad enough he wanted to kill Ms. Vasquez, but to think that he tried to frame me for the murder makes me sad.
Tell me why, Mr. Wright. Huh?
Tell me. Why did Mr. Hammer want to blame me?
Well, this is what I think. Mr. Hammer wanted to put the blame on you because...
Take that!
Because you were the Steel Samurai.
Because I was a Steel Samurai?
Mr. Hammer was a big star once. He was reduced to acting in a kid's show. And as the villain to boot. The kids love the Steel Samurai. So he hated you.
I think I understand. Sniff. He could have just told me. I would have changed places with him any time.
I think you're missing the point.
Thank you. I'm just glad it's all over.
So am I. So am I.
Congratulations, WP.
Oh. Thanks to you, I'll be able to don the Steel Samurai outfit once more. I can't wait to get back into that sweaty costume, man.
Huh? Is something wrong?
No, of course not. Nick, Edgeworth.
Say something right. I'm not good at small talk. Huh?
What?
That was too bad, Edgeworth. You don't waste any time gloating, do you? No, I really want to thank you. Vasquez would have gotten away if you hadn't stepped in.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Bowers. Snip.
Edgeworth. I'm a big fan of your work, Mr. Bowers. Fire. Right? Must say, I hadn't expected to meet you again after all these years.
But meet again?
However, in retrospect, it would have been better had we not met. Thanks to you, I'm saddled with unnecessary feelings. Unnecessary feelings. Keep in your pants there, Edgeworth. Yes, unease and uncertainty. Are those kind of things kind of necessary? They serve to get in my way. Listen to me, Phoenix Wright. Don't ever show your face in front of me again, or I'll kiss it. I'll kiss it for you. I'll kiss it, and I won't stop kissing it. Thanks, Edgeworth.
Mr. Wright? Was that guy your friend?
What? Friends, as if? They're rivals. Rivals, right, Nick?
For now we are, I guess.
None.
Why do I get the feeling I'm missing something? Come on, Nick. Tell me, what's the deal with you and Edgeworth?
He's my baby mama.
Ta-doy! Nick, this is it. The new show starts today. You're going to watch it with me, right?
I'll admit, I was kind of surprised. They'd seriously go through with it.
You have to buy the trading cards too, okay? We had to trade with Cody and that assistant.
Fine, I'll do it.
Isn't it great that WP gets to play the lead role again? I wonder if they'll show his real face this time.
I don't know. I don't think the world's ready for the real Mr. Powers.